But to start with, how do you even know which motorcycle to use to convert to electric in the first place? I mean, some have got to make better conversions than others, right? Well, that's true. So let's go outside and we'll take a look at a gasoline motorcycle and decide if it would make an appropriate electric conversion. So here we have a real-world example of a gasoline-powered motorcycle that we can take a look at and see if it would make a good candidate for an electric conversion. Just to look at to start with, it's in pretty good overall condition. The chrome is pretty shiny. There's very little rust on it, just a little bit on the muffler over here, which is typical. Hot components tend to corrode faster. Other than that, though, it looks fairly good overall. So let's take a look at some of the individual characteristics here. For one thing, right away I notice it has passenger pegs and a passenger seat. And well, that's not necessarily a very specific thing in what the weight capacity is going to be. Typically, if a motorcycle is designed to carry a passenger, it's going to already have the strength of the frame and the strength of the suspension for carrying the additional weight of some batteries. Another thing I notice is the actual design of the motorcycle. We have a pair of tubes that make up the frame coming down in front, and then the transmission and engine and other components bolt right into that. So we have a number of good attachment points for both the batteries and the electric motor that we can see are points where the engine and transmission already mount into the frame. Another thing I want to test out is that most of the components actually work. For example, if I turn on the ignition, the starter works, the headlights, turn lights, and tail signals all work on this motorcycle. Now, it does have a problem with the carburetors, and because of that, the motorcycle won't start and run, but that does mean that I'll be able to pull out the transmission and engine and sell those as parts, yet everything else on here I'll be able to reuse for the electric motorcycle conversion. So I'm going to say that overall, I think this would make a pretty good motorcycle candidate for an electric conversion. Now, this one happens to be a 1981 Kawasaki KZ440. Is that important? Not particularly, except that in this case, it's the exact same make, model, and year as the motorcycle that I'm going to convert to electric.